Hallelujah. I'm so privileged to be with you again on Daily Reflections today, where we reflect from the daily devotional written by Pastor E. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, the Open Heavens. My name is Aderunke Mosuro. I'm the pastor of the Covenant Assembly, a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God in Chatham, Kent. The topic before us today is Sure Path to Greatness. Sure Path to Greatness. And our Bible passage is taken from the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verses 17 to 21. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the greatness, the exceeding greatness of his power to us word who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places, far above principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in the world to come. And the memory verse is from Psalm 48, verse 1. And it says, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised in the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness. Our reflections. The memory verse of today reminds us of the greatness of our God. He deserves all our praise and adoration. What is also mind-blowing is that God has made all of his children great. Everyone in them has a seed of greatness. We have many examples in the Bible of those whom God made great, and we are no exception to this. John 14:12 says, most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also, and greater works than these will he do, because I go to my Father. Every believer can do what Christ did, as well as greater things, greater exploits, requires an empowerment with the Holy Spirit as evidenced in the ministry of the early disciples after the day of Pentecost, as recorded in the scriptures in the book of Acts chapter 2, verses 1 to 4. The word works in John 14, 12 refers to miracles, healings, signs, wonders, and mighty acts of power. John 5, 20 says, for the Father loves the Son, and shows him all things that he himself does, and he will show him greater works than these, that you may marvel. If you want to be an overcomer all the time, the Holy Spirit must be an indispensable companion to you. You need the Holy Spirit to be able to attack Satan, to defeat him, and to set the captives free. From a Bible passage, we also see that we need wisdom, revelation, and knowledge of God. Once your eyes are enlightened and you know who you are in Christ and the power available to you, then you'll be on the path to greatness. The title of today's devotion gives us a hint that there is a pathway to greatness. It is not an instantaneous thing. Pastor Adeboye reminds us today that all those in the Bible who became great didn't start out that way. In fact, most of them had humble beginnings. Our Lord Jesus Christ was born in the manger, and all others in the Bible, you would see that they came from humble beginnings. So don't look at where you are now as where you will end. You have not reached your destination. Dream big, trust God, seek him more, learn of who he is and who you are, and stay focused. Action point: a dream encourages you to pay some price now and reap the reward later. Can I encourage you to dream big and to be encouraged to pay the price? May the Lord help you. Till I see you again. Bye.